engineering is becoming automated. Artificial intelligence can design the perfect tools for machines, precisely tuned for specific tasks. And these machines save resources. Used plastic packaging and cups are converted into high-grade, long-lasting products. Artificial intelligence has perfected the process of plastic recycling. A part of this vision has already been implemented by Veka AG, a company based in the Westphalian town of Sendenhorst. Veka is the market leader in the production of window profiles made of synthetic materials. They manufacture 120,000 kilometers of PVC profiles annually. These profiles are then processed into shutters, sliding doors, or window frames. We would like to use artificial intelligence to optimize our machines. It would allow us to produce tools faster and more efficiently, ultimately conserving resources. Before a new window frame can be produced, a machine tool must be manufactured. Once in place, liquid plastic is funneled through the device, creating a new profile. Constructing such a device is the result of weeks of engineering and complex, arduous metal processing. The tool, known as an extrusion head, is installed in a machine. Thick liquid plastic is pressed through the device by a spiraled screw conveyor, forming a strand of plastic. Then the strand passes through a cooling section, a never-ending flow of synthetic material held in place by special tools. Once the process is completed, the profiles can be cut into any length. The quality, though, is rarely top grade after the first try. The staff operating the machines communicate extensively with the machinists, providing feedback and insight on how to improve the extrusion heads. Testing and optimization can be repeated up to 12 times, each trial requiring substantial amounts of material and electricity. The entire process, from completing a machine tool till finalizing a product, takes about half a year. Our goal for tool making is to cut resource consumption by half. In order to create a finished profile, nearly 10 tons of PVC are required for testing alone. The waste can be reused for production, but this recycling process also requires energy. However, an up-and-coming mid-sized IT company in Dortmund has specialized in optimizing these kinds of processes. The IANUS Simulation GmbH has an interdisciplinary team consisting of mathematicians, engineers, and computer scientists to analyze the flow processes in tools like extrusion heads, for example. The goal of these experts is the perfect simulation of the production process with the help of a so-called digital twin. A digital twin uses every bit of information available to a business for its simulation. The information that has been collected can then be used to further optimize the production process in a computer instead of doing a real test. To create this digital twin and make the perfect simulation of the production process, the experts in Dortmund use the CAD data of the real machine tool. They are most interested in the area through which the plastic melt flows. This area is broken down into hundreds of millions of tiny cubes. Each one has a length of approximately 1/10 of a millimeter. Thanks to their models, IT experts are able to determine the slightest change in temperature, pressure, and acceleration that occurs inside the plastic smelter. All of the variances and physical properties can be displayed visually and color coordinated. A complete simulation of a production process enabled by a digital twin. Ideally, the liquid plastic would flow over the machine tool surface with pretty much the exact same speed. Only then does the material have the strength and durability that Veka is seeking. At Veka AG, these digital twins are already in use. With the help of computer simulation, the engineers can determine which construction delivers the best results. This enables them to dramatically reduce the number of trial runs with the actual tool, inevitably saving resources. Normally, we use 12 samples for each machine tool. By using the digital twin, we can reduce this to 6 samples, which means we save 5 tons of material and 1,000 kilowatt hours in electricity. At BBM Maschinenbau GmbH in Langenberg, Westphalia, the focus is also on efficiency when dealing with plastic. This medium-sized company produces so-called extrusion blow molding plants. Hollow forms, such as canisters or barrels, as well as parts for the automobile industry, are manufactured using this technology. To save resources, the engineers try to use as much recycled material as possible. During this process, the recycled material flows over a so-called extruder within the machine. Simultaneously, another, new plastic flows over 2 other extruders in the production facility. In this special spiral distributor, the old and new plastics are brought together to form a tube. The tube is then separated and, under high pressure, is blown into a mold. This is how a barrel is formed. Most significantly, only the inner and outer coating of the barrel consists of new plastic. The rest of the barrel's wall is recycled material. Thus, the outside layer of the barrel looks like new, and the inner layer allows the barrel to be filled with chemicals. The challenge for the engineers is to use as much recycled material as possible. However, recycled plastic is not easy to process because it is derived from different sources. Goods are collected in plastic bags, which are then shredded. These goods can stem from barrels, packaging plastics, or even slag. They are mixed together. The result is an undefined material, which is difficult to process. It needs to be studied and optimized by AI for us to continue processing it. In order to use as much recycled material as possible, the IT experts in Dortmund have produced another digital twin. This time, though, it is a spiral distributor which blends the new and the recycled plastics in the machine. With the help of AI, the engineers can optimize this according to an age-old principle. It is an evolutionary principle that we have learned by imitating nature. Our designs are mutated little by little over generations. In the end, this hones an optimal result. In the first step, artificial intelligence software designs different spiral distributors. The edges of the spirals have differing widths and differing heights. The gradient is also varied. And so, thousands of different variants are created. The production process is simulated with differing individuals. The same exact thing occurs with the digital twin, but this time with millions of digital copies. Intelligent software determines the best of variations, which can be filled with as much recycled plastic as possible, and nevertheless, produce strong and stable barrels. The best 30% are chosen and form a new generation, just like the evolutionary principle, survival of the fittest. Their construction is analyzed. Artificial intelligence tries to recognize the principles which make them the best. According to these principles, new digital twins, or copies, are developed. The same goes for the thousands of individuals. After this, production is started over once again, each with a selection of the best. In essence, an evolutionary principle induces constantly improving results. And after 10 generations, an optimal spiral distributor has been created. At BBM Maschinenbau, the spiral distributor has already been optimized according to the revolutionary principle. The result is very impressive. The barrels are stable and can be used for many years. They consist of 80% clear recycled plastic. The blue inner and outer layers consist of approximately 10%. Up until now, only products of poor quality with a short lifespan have been manufactured from recycled plastic, and there was no complete cycle. This can change, however. At the moment, there is only a virtual reality model of a blow molding plant. However, the decisive machine tool is constantly being improved and optimized with the help from AI. If and when this machine goes into operation, it will be capable of manufacturing a high-quality, stable, watertight boat made for the most part from recycled packaging and barrels. After years of use, the boat itself can then be recycled. Will AI take over engineering in the future? AI will not steal engineers their jobs. They will simply use the AI to their advantage and work more efficiently. Artificial intelligence contributes to the improvement of plastic recycling and, indeed, will eventually close the circle of substance recycling. This will save energy and material. However, for an efficient handling of resources, further challenges still remain. And that means a lot of work for engineers.